how well his success has truly been one of the feel-good stories in mixed martial arts over the last several years. Charles Oliveira kind of left for dead by people in 2018, then went on to become the best lightweight in the world and still believes he can be that yet again if he can get a win tonight.
He's got to win tonight. He's got to get going in the right direction. You lose your championship in the way that he did, you question whether or not Oliveira has the mental makeup to get back going in the right direction. How can you question it, though, when we have seen what he has done prior? This guy is a tremendous striker, unbelievable jiu-jitsu. If you're on the ground with him, you're constantly in danger. He can submit you from any single position. Charles Oliveira is special, man, and it's always fun to be able to call one of his fights.
And I'm not sure, minute for minute, there is a more exciting fighter in mixed martial arts today than Charles Oliveira. And thankfully, the MMA masses get to watch him compete yet again here tonight. As I am, as Conor McGregor returns to the proving ground here tonight. This is the biggest superstar in mixed martial arts history and a damn good fighter, too. Let's see what he does here tonight.
I have no horse in the race, but the butterflies are kicking my stomach up and down because every time Conor steps into the octagon, it feels like a momentous occasion. Yeah. One of the biggest stars in all of sports. He transcends the sport of mixed martial arts. A guy that has a fantastic left hand. He's very quick. He's a master of managing distance, managing space, and the speed and the ability, the eyes of Conor McGregor is something that we don't pay enough attention to when we watch him fight.
And of course, every time he competes, all eyes are on Conor McGregor, and yet more often than not, he doesn't show up flat on fight night. He rises to the occasion. The Jose Aldo fight certainly is the one that people will historically talk about, but let's see how it goes in this spot for Conor here tonight. To get us started, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC Lightweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the challenger, Charles Dupont Oliveira. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world, the notorious Conor McGregor!
Herbert Dean's in the building. He is the third man in the octagon tonight. Boa noite! That is Brazilian Portuguese. Oh, damaging knee to the head! Bone on bone. Nicely done with the high kick. Oh, he lands that teep. By McGregor.
I mean, Conor McGregor is a fantastic striker, and once again, that skill is on his pitch.
Well, few fighters manage distance as efficiently and as well as Conor McGregor, and there's that left hand finding its home early.
Oh, he does a great job of setting you up, man. You saw it in the Jose Aldo fight. The guy will just step back a little bit and bang, drops the straight left on you that can end your night. He not only throws this fast, he also is so accurate, and that allows him to finish so many fights.
All right, half guard position here, DC. You have an extra hop in your step when you talk about fighters working out. Oh, tight submission attempt now with the Dars.
Oh my goodness, that Dars choke is very tight. Connor's choke locked in, it's only a matter of time. But he cannot rush. He's got to control his opponent so he doesn't lose him in the scramble.
Oh, he got out. How good is that?
This guy is so aware. He never leaves anything long to allow for himself to get subbed.
McGregor's got the full mount. Ground and pound keeps coming. Good movement to avoid that damage coming down. All right, so some high-level stuff there on the ground, but as they make their way back to the feet, huge response from the crowd, no surprise.
I loved it. I loved all the grappling that was on display there, but fight fans want to see striking, and that's exactly what they're going to get as he finally makes his way back to his feet.
Oliveira gets touched by that kick there. Looks like he's trying to set up a takedown here. There's the attempt. Nice land there by Conor McGregor. You know, DC, he's got a great frame for this featherweight division. Very long, extended reach, and he uses it pretty well. Works off of that jab beautifully, and he is on point here tonight. Another takedown attempt, not there.
Devastating body kick lands.
Right hand, yup. Just misses there with the left. Takedown defense holds up.
Oh,
well, he has stayed busy and he has stayed accurate. Nice combination.
Very accurate, a lot of activity in the hands. Looks phenomenal tonight.
Oliveira doing the right things defensively. Oh, big knee there for Oliveira. Past the two-minute mark in round one. Oliveira gets stung by that leg kick.
He's got that single collar tie.
Oh, ties another takedown. Nice shot there by Oliveira. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. All right, north-south position now. We'll see who transitions first.
Got to watch his neck. That guillotine is tight. Good job by the champ there. Sliding back out.
Well, sometimes our stat guys are stingy with these submission attempt numbers. There have been a lot of them here. Submission defense has held up every step of the way.
Yeah, he's a great grappler, and he's really, really good defensively.
All right, so he's got the body locked down here, DC, or so it appears. This is not a guy you want anywhere near your back. So Charles Oliveira came in with a decided grappling advantage in this matchup, and he has taken full advantage of that perceived edge.
Yeah, Charles Oliveira is the best on the ground. He is...
Oh, submission attempts in bunches tonight. Oh, compromising spot here. Triangle choke is locked in. Well, the ground and pound has been on point tonight. Good work here by Oliveira. Well, he's got his back now. Oh, excellent pressure here from top position by Oliveira.
Look at that. Recognize he's about to lose position. He's got to be careful here.
Final seconds of the round. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Right. Round two is next. Hey,
stop.
Sit down. Take a deep breath. Now listen, you probably lost that round. I need you to be first. Let's get that head movement and start popping that jab.
All right, now we take a look back at some of the action in that previous round, DC. A lot to like on both sides here.
I mean, both were intent on going forward. And what happens when nobody wants to take a step back? They meet in the middle. That's exactly what they did, and they both found success over the course of that round.
Round two, Conor McGregor versus Charles Oliveira.
Ready.
All right, next round is underway, and man, is he tough to submit, right? No lack of effort, but unable to get that submission in the previous round.
He does a great job of staying patient. He doesn't rush or panic, which allows him to defend with the right frame of mind, and that's why he's never been submitted.
Ooh, nice defense. I thought that punch might get through.
Oh,
huge strike lands there, and somehow his opponent's chin held up.
His opponent's chin held up, but you do not want to be on the receiving end of those types of strikes.
Nice straight right lands.
These boys are standing right in front of each other, just kind of going at it.
Oh, he's in a world of trouble now. Oh, big left hand there.
He's hurting him bad, man. That right hook is nasty.
And how good is this? Both men going for the finish.
Oh, my goodness.
A lot of different looks. He switches to southpaw now. Get that end swell on it between rounds if we get there. McGregor gets up and decides to take this fight back to the feet despite having a dominant position on the ground. Strike lands cleanly there. Man, has his chin been tested early.
That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yeah. Still plenty of time to go here, round two.
That was a beautiful hook. It landed perfectly, and it hurt his opponent very bad.
Well, no denying that he rocked him, but couldn't quite get the finish.
He hurt him real bad, but he couldn't find the shot that would put him to sleep. He threw a lot of punches, but he couldn't get the one to land on the button that would end the night.
Nice strike by him there, and perhaps opened up a cut. Yeah, he's bleeding now.
Yeah, opened up a cut. It's not bad, right? It's not a bad cut. We got to keep an eye on it.
Nice job by Conor McGregor on the feet. You got to think his longtime chief corner, John Kavanaugh, likes what he is seeing out of his pupil early tonight. Oliveira gets the single leg takedown. Nicely done there.
You see him put himself into the half guard? Like the control, yep.
Oliveira's going for a choke here.
That Darce choke is tight. There it is.
Oh, he got out.
He did a great job of getting his hips away and getting back to his back in order to defend that Darce choke.
Well, this is kind of crazy the way this is transpiring. This jiu-jitsu fighter looks like a professional boxer here tonight. He told us about his evolution. He has absolutely taken it to the next level.
He has taken it to the next level, J.A. I mean, this guy is so comfortable in the striking. Before in his career, early, he looked a little bit lost. He looked like he was desperate to get takedowns. Now, he seems to be comfortable everywhere. So the work that they are putting in is truly paying dividends.
Well, we got a lot of blood now, ladies and gentlemen. All right, he's got the hooks in, DC, working off of his back.
Now look for him to attack the neck of his opponent to try to get the rear choke. Oh, in the mouth.
Oh, what a moment there as they make their way back to the feet. Crowd may be drunk, but they're absolutely loving it.
Yeah, the crowd loves the stand-up fight. So all that grappling wasn't what they wanted to see. They're back up on their feet now, and they're popping for it. They're excited.
Really seeing things well offensively here tonight, and he's caused a lot of swelling there on his opponent.
You gotta address this now, because it's only going to get worse. Your opponent is not gonna let you off the hook. You gotta move, you gotta change something to try to deter him from going to that spot. Oh, nice. Oh, nice takedown defense. He does a great job getting out of that clinch position.
Well, champ, I don't see that well, but it's hard to miss the redness underneath that elbow. A lot of bodily investment from his opponent tonight.
Yeah, it's an investment, John. It may not pay dividends right now, but the more you go there, the more damage you do, eventually it will show itself. Right now, it's starting to show.
10 minutes in the books. All right, so the round is over, and you see some obvious bleeding now. Looks like the cut is on the nose. Yes, it is. Cutman will try to get in there and shut it, but of course, as soon as he absorbs a strike this next round, that thing could reopen. Certainly bears watching here moving forward. All right, back to the stool, and he is officially swole, and I'm not talking about muscles. He is swollen up top.
I mean, he looks bad. It's because he was too stationary. He was on the receiving end of too many big shots. He was beat up. He was battered. He was bruised. And look at all the swelling. It shows that he has taken far too many.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight.
Just turning his hip over into the leg kick.
Oh, and he tags him with the straight hand there. Beautifully done by McGregor. Wow, what a head kick. Oh, he lands another strike to the body here. Really starting to connect on a lot of strikes to the midsection here in the latter stages of this fight. Nice. Nicely done. Shot finds the target there.
Great shot lands. Now he's got to go find that follow-up attempt. The kill shot is what they call it to go and end the fight.
Wow, this fight's been pretty crazy thus far. Both guys doling out a lot of damage, and neither seems too bothered by it, but clearly both parties are hurt.
Both guys are hurt. Both guys are fighting beautifully. Both are showing a lot of heart right now in this fight. They're both doing amazing jobs. Let's see who gets the job done at the end of this thing.
Side control now.
Yeah, he's trying to get to the Dars here.
All right, looks like that Dars is tight.
Tight submission locked in. Dars choke seems to be very close to being finished. He cannot get excited, though. He's got to be patient. Wait, take his time, and the finish will show itself.
Oh, flatten him on his back there. Well, his superior grappling has certainly been the lead narrative in this one. The takedowns, the ground control, he's got it all going tonight.
He's doing a great job of dictating to his opponent, not allowing him to make any decisions in regards to the fight.
Oliveira's nose is bleeding now. Yes, looks as though he got cut by one of those offerings from his opponent. Nice spinning attack there and able to land to the body.
Any body kick may finish his fight. It does not have to be the front one up the middle.
Strike right there. I'm not sure how many more of these his opponent can take.
Massive shot that he landed. Great job.
All right, so some definite damage underneath the elbow now on the side of his opponent. A lot of strikes to the body starting out.
Yeah, a lot of strikes to the body. And mixing up the impact, not being one-dimensional, not headhunting inside the octagon. I think he has fought beautifully right now. He's starting to show it.
Oliveira's in half goal. All right, side control now. 2 minutes now to go. All right, north-south position now, DC. We'll see how he chooses to advance from here. Oliveira's looking for a Dars choke here.
It's tight.
Oh, looks like he might get the finish here.
This has to be it, John. It's got to be it.
Charles Oliveira back with style points tonight.
Man.
Wow, an unbelievable result here tonight by way of submission. And he bided his time there. He stayed patient, waited for an opening, and then when it was there, he certainly capitalized to get the tap here tonight. All right, so a wild round and a wild sequence there on the ground, DC. Talk us through the highlight.
He's such a phenomenal grappler. I don't understand how people don't know that this guy wants to submit you. He is the best grappler, best submission specialist we've seen in a long time.
All right, here now, Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 13 seconds of round number three. Declaring the winner by submission due to a Dars choke, and the new UFC lightweight champion of the world, Charles the Bronx Oliveira.
All right, Buff, thank you very much. And there it is yet again, Charles Oliveira adding to his submission total here with a win tonight.
New Bronx.